this is some of our oldest born autumn cows and calves. So we are taking them back to the farm this afternoon, as they'll be coming inside because the cows are to get their BVD and lepto booster vaccine, and the calves are to get their first pneumonia vaccine. So they get one jab now, and then in I think 3 to 4 weeks from now they get their booster jab, so they'll be inside for that anyway. Hoping to maybe get them back outside. The weather looks slightly more settled these next few days, so we potentially might put some of them back outside, but as I've said before, you know, I need to keep the grass for my yows also to top on, so it's a bit of a fine balance. Don't want to take them in too soon, as that'll give us a long winter and use up a lot of our feed supply, but we also don't want to eat too much of the grass because I need it for the yows. So yeah, as long as it stays dry and the ground condition can hold them, I think we'll try and keep them outside as long as we can, but it all very much depends on what the weather does. We might plan to leave them out for another week, or we might plan that today and then tomorrow they might be coming inside. So you just never know. Bedded, ready for the open day. So shed's all ready for the open day tomorrow. I have just come up onto what we call the big hill here, where our spring herd is, and just going for a wee drive around them, see how they're getting on. And I've also taken some fresh sheep super blocks out to the yows as well, who are up here too. So I just thought I'd give you a wee update on our spring calves. These calves will be getting weaned sort of start November. The cows will come back up to this hill where they will stay until mid-January. The calves will then come inside to our new lambing shed, where the Pari and the vino setup will obviously be coming down, and then the calves will stay there until February. In February they get sold as about 10 to 12 months old through one of our local marts, and then the shed will get turned around ready for lambing. And as you can see here, I got a wee surprise when I went onto the camera to check them in the morning. It did take me a minute just to make sure that this was another calf in front of her. And sure enough, it was. So she calved them both herself, and a lovely set she's got too. Now, this makes it set number 11 that we've had this autumn, which is probably one of the most amounts of twins we've ever had. Obviously not all successful, but that's the joys of twins, unfortunately. You win some, you lose some.
down. Wait.
Our to Pari open day, so just taking the ewe lambs in here, as these will be the sheep that I'm using for the demonstrations throughout the day. These lambs haven't been through the to Pari very often. I think this will probably be their second time through, so I felt like this would be much fairer than using the ewes who have obviously been through it for a few years now. So this could go one of two ways, but we'll wait and see. I'm sure it'll be fine. So just taking them inside now, the open day starts at 10. So just going to take them in and try and keep them out of this rain, because it is meant to be pretty miserable today. So we shall see what like. Hoping for a reasonable turnout. I think there's over 50 people were registered to attend. So I'm looking forward to welcoming people to the farm today. All go today, so not only have we got our open day, but we also have got the Harbro Super Bruiser in about. So this is the lorry that comes in about to bruise the barley on farm. Now, as I've explained before, we needed this barley bruised and out the road so that we can get cows in if we need to. So the barley comes, once it's bruised, comes out the back there onto the elevator and then up into the shed. This is just obviously the temporary storage, we'll have to shift it again. But the hopper at the front there gets filled with the whole barley, then it gets passed through into the bruiser where it gets slightly rolled, then prop corn is also added to the barley to preserve it, and then it goes along into the conveyor and up and into the shed. So 60 ton was bruised in about 2 hours. I'm glad to get a seat. It has been a really, really good day. Great turnout of people. I hope it was really informative for people. I hope they found it interesting. I sort of did a wee bit of explaining and then just left people to have a play about with it, let them see how the machine worked, you know, look around it, do see different setups, etc. So yeah, it was very much a case of a day for other people to see it, to play with it, to get an understanding of how the Pari works, see the Vino setup as well in action. I find it beneficial to, you know, have a play about with it and you know, see how it works yourself, as opposed to someone just standing there saying, this is the bit of kit, this is what it does. So yeah, hopefully it was beneficial to some people. Lots of interest, lots of great questions. So I really enjoyed it. I really love welcoming people onto the farm and letting them, you know, see these sort of things or see what we do, see how we farm, and being quizzed on why we do things and how we do things. You know, that's how you learn, is by sort of asking all these questions and speaking to all these people. So yeah, it was really good.
like I said, really enjoyed it. It's been hectic. just getting everything ready and, you know, the yow lambs in and sorted, etc. So it's been a started in the dark and finished in the dark kind of day, but oh, it's not been too bad. It's been enjoyable, like I say. So and fantastic catering as always from Fiona. She did a fantastic job, so that was good. Nice plate of stovies in the middle of the day, which was needed. Yeah, no, all in all, I think really good. I think Elliot and Giles from Pari are really pleased as well, so that's positive. And yeah, just thanks for everyone that showed up, and I hope it was of interest. Please, you know, always feel free to give feedback. I know the team at Pari as well, they'll be interested to hear your thoughts on how it went, and you know, if there's anything that you think we could improve on or change or include, then, you know, more than welcome to try and accommodate your ideas. So yeah, really good for the first one. I think it was really good. Thankfully the rain didn't come too much until now. It's heavy now, but no, thankfully it held off. So thank you again. I hope you had a good day, and yeah, please let us know in the comments or message us, get in touch with Tamari, whatever. But yeah, thanks again, and I'm gonna go grab a cup of tea and some food. Thanks again. See you for the next one.